ChatGPT is only as good as your prompts. And in this video, I'm gonna walk you through one of my favorite prompts, the ACT as an expert prompt. I'm gonna show you exactly how I use it and how you can use it to get better results from AI chatbots. My mission is to help 1 million people thrive with AI. If that's you, this is the time to hit subscribe. Let's crush it with AI. And let me share my screen. Now, what we're gonna do here is I'm gonna show you an example of the results that we get with the ACT as an expert prompt and without the ACT as an expert prompt. So let's start by typing this in. Please analyze my side hustle strategy. I wanna buy items from garage sales, then resell on eBay. I'm kind of like channeling my inner Gary V. Now, why the ACT as an expert prompt is so important is because it gives your AI bot, it gives ChatGPT the context it needs to give you the answer that you want. If you go in with a really broad question like analyze my side hustle, it's giving all sorts of different pieces of information, but maybe there's certain pieces of information that are very, very important to me. So let's go ahead here and let's analyze this strategy a little bit more closely, because right now it's giving market research, sourcing, financial analysis, listing and marketing, legal and logistical considerations, scaling and growth. And each one of these parts of the business plan, of your side hustle plan, could be pages and pages long. But let's go back in, let's start a new chat here. And I encourage you to test this along with me. But instead of just saying, please analyze my side hustle strategy, at the beginning of the prompt, we're gonna act as my finance expert. And then let's see if that changes the results. All right, so let's look at these side by side. Here on the right, I've got our first example, which is very general, but in our second example, it's still giving us a lot of the same information, but it's much more specific to the financial considerations, okay? Items at garage sales are typically sold at very low prices, which can lead to high margins. Con, they can be unpredictable, more time commitment. eBay has a vast customer base, fixed prices, profit margins. So, again, what's interesting here is when we ask it to assess the side hustle based on finances, every single answer comes within that context of money, of financing. Okay, even the time commitment part is a little bit more into that. But you know, look, we come down here to financial considerations, which we did not get a very intensive financial consideration information here on our first try. But now we need to think about purchase price of items, eBay listing fees, PayPal fees, shipping costs, packaging materials, revenue, sale price of items on eBay. We're gonna need to calculate our profit margins, risk management. We need to think about inventory risk, market fluctuations, condition and authenticity, legal and tax implications. So again, you can see that by simply adding that small bit of context, asking it to be an expert in what we really need our help in, it's gonna give us a much more robust answer. Now let's try one more example on this same example before we move to our next question here. So we're gonna again ask it to analyze our side hustle strategy, but in this case, we wanted to act as an expert in eBay marketing. And now let's see if it's gonna give us something that's a little bit more focused on SEO, keywords, things like that. It's gonna be maybe a little bit less focused on the financing spot. So let's see, let's test. Let's see how it works here. Okay, so sourcing items, focusing on neighborhoods with higher income as they tend to have higher quality items. That's interesting. I wouldn't have necessarily thought of that immediately, but that makes sense. They often have antiques, collectibles, blah, blah, blah. Item selection, use eBay's completed listings feature to see what similar items have sold for. That's great. That is what marketing is here. Ensure the items, blah, blah, blah. Again, some of this stuff is still pretty general, but what we do here, and I think where AI really excels is brainstorming and thinking through. You combine the power of AI with the power of this brain here between your ears, and you can really come up with some, and that's where I love it, where I can come up with ideas that I hadn't maybe thought of at first. And this is where it takes you from a beginner to an intermediate to an expert much more quickly than say, if you were just using general Google stuff. Cause now I can go and I'm gonna show you an example of this cause I just love this stuff. Right, pricing strategy, listing optimization, and I can just go deeper. So like for example, maybe I really like this listing optimization stuff, or for example, let's go back up here to the competitive pricing research, right? So how can I effectively research items on eBay? And again, I don't want to go too deep into the example because I just want to get your juices flowing, because your job here is to take this act as an expert and start testing it this week. Start testing it this week. And by the way, I have 52 prompts. Every week we go through a new prompt. You can go through your own challenge to become an absolute killer, slayer, destroyer with AI. Go to AIupdate.ai, AIupdate.ai. I'll put a link below and you can get your own 52-week challenge started. So you can start really, really optimizing and crushing it with AI. So again, look, we're going just a step deeper. Effectively researching items on eBay is crucial for understanding market demand, yada, yada, yada. This is one thing that it loves to do. It loves to kind of ramble a little bit. That's okay. That's okay. We're going to get in here into the meat. Use eBay search function. Analyze completed listings. Check active listings. Keyword optimization. Item conditions in description. Like, this is incredible. By the way, you could turn this into an entire blog. Gosh, you can see that I get so excited. I get so jazzed up about this, which is why I'm really committed to helping you and a million people really thrive with AI. So anyway, you can see that how by simply adding a little bit of context, act as an expert, it gives the context to our AI bot that it needs to give us the result that we want. We want information on financing, we want information on marketing, we want information on taxes, we want legal implications. You can ask it to act as an expert and it's going to give you a better result. And by better, I mean a more accurate result based on what you need for your specific situation. Okay, let's run through one more example. Does that sound good? Let's run through one more example that might help you professionally and get your brains kind of jogged. And again, you can use this to act as an expert in personal health, act as an expert in dating, act as an expert in marketing, sales, accounting, all these different types of act as an expert ideas, and you can really start to fine tune your results. Let's look at another example here. So first we're gonna start with asking it and saying, I want to generate more sales for my business. Again, this is, quite frankly, this is a horrible prompt because it doesn't give the AI bot enough information. And again, this is why I think this is this project, why this challenge, why learning these AI tools is so important, because the better your prompt, the better your result. The better your result, the more effective of a human being you're gonna be as we go into this AI revolution. So anyway, we ask it to generate, I say, hey, I wanna generate more sales for my business, right? And it's gonna come back and say, we wanna optimize your targeting strategy, content marketing through leadership, improve your sales funnel, partnerships and networking. So it's giving us a lot of kind of like very general ideas. If we came in and we said, we wanted to be more specific to like my roofing business, and I want to sell to commercial real estate rather than personally owned buildings, like you can give it more context. But anyway, we're gonna focus on the act as an expert. So now that we've got this, it's giving us a bunch of like kind of like general ideas. Let's get a little bit more specific. And so we're gonna ask it to act as an expert in Facebook marketing. I wanna generate more sales for my business. Let's see if it's gonna be a little bit more specific, because we've asked it to act as an expert in a very, very specific function. Because if I wanna generate more sales for my business, there's a million things I can do, but we wanna specifically focus on it being our Facebook marketing expert. So define your target audience, customer avatar, audience insights. Use Facebook audience insights and again, this is where the gas is. It says use Facebook audience insights to understand your target audience's demographics, interests, and behaviors. Create compelling content, engaging posts, visual content, live videos. And by the way, if you said, as you're reading through this, you might say, that sounds like a good idea. Give me more information on this. And that's where you could start to, once you start to go down the rabbit hole, you can kind of funnel your information from being broad to very specific to what your exact next steps should be. Leverage Facebook ads, custom audiences, lookalike audiences, ad types, ad copy. Utilize Facebook groups, create a group, engage in other groups, retargeting campaigns. You can see how you can start to develop your entire Facebook marketing strategy right here. And by the way, let's say you decided, I don't actually want to do all the Facebook marketing on my own, right? You can leverage this tool to give you good questions to ask. So again, you don't want to do all of your Facebook marketing. You want to outsource it. You want to hire someone. So you schedule some consultation calls with some Facebook marketing experts. When you get on the call, by using ChatGPT, you're going to go into that call much more well-informed, and you're going to know the right questions to ask. You're going to have an idea of the right answers to get back. You can ask more specific data questions. You're going to be more well-informed so that you hire the right person on the offset. So again, just a quick example of how asking ChatGPT to act as an expert in a specific field can 10x your results by giving just a little bit more context. See, that one sentence completely transforms the way that we get our answers. Type in the comments below, what's a way that you can use act as an expert to really solve problems more effectively? I want to hear from you. Type it below. Thanks for liking and subscribing, and I will catch you in the next video. Peace.